You can be assured that Boston College's coaches saw that from up top, that they did not cover a guy in that formation, and they'll probably come back to that later on.
On the sideline, Brian St-Pierre. We asked him yesterday, what's your feeling about this? He said, I don't like it very much.
You know, he went through the same thing last year, but now that he's the starter and somebody comes in and spells him, he's not liking that very much because he doesn't want to lose the rhythm of the game. And that's something that I can agree with.
Third down, short drop, and a slam. It's caught by Reed again. And I think they're going to give him enough for first down here. They're going to give him a very favorable spot.
Well, it looks like forward progress was in his favor, and he did get across the stick. It's a little three-step slant pass to Reed here, and he makes a great catch, and his forward momentum is across the line. Great spot by the official. Nice coverage by Fernandez, but it's just a little too late. Reed does a great job of getting his body in front of the football.
Yeah, the numbers on Reed, four catches, 43 yards, and a touchdown. That was a tough catch. First down for the freshman quarterback, Quentin Porter. Give it to Green. Green trying to get outside. There was a hold. I don't know if it's going to get flagged. Yeah,
there it is.
So I think that one's going to come back.
They have done a great job on Corral and Mr. Green tonight. They've really gotten people to the football. They've done a great job of staying in their lanes, not letting him bounce to the outside. Nice run defense tonight.
So we will wait for the call. I'm sure I saw a hold. One thing Stanford is doing, Warren, is they are taking William Green out of this game so far.
They really have, and like I said, they're playing great lanes.
Holding, offense, penalty occurred beyond the line of scrimmage, 10 yards from the spot of the foul. First down.
Barry Tompkins, Warren Moon, Jim Watson. We're at Stanford Stadium as night has set in fully here. And a day that was in the 80s and an evening, which is probably, what, low 70s? Just perfect.
Beautiful night here in the Bay Area, Southern Northern California.
Yeah, the BC players were saying how much they enjoyed coming out here to the West Coast. Next year, Stanford goes back to Boston. There's Porter out of the shotgun. He airs it out. He's got the world out of here. Playing center field. Tank Williams. Asimba Hadari with the interception.
Nice play by Hadari. That ball just hung up in the air, and he's able to get over there and make the big interception. Does what you want every defensive back to do. Catch that ball at its highest point. He's got Fernandez beat, but he comes over and makes the big play. Just what Stanford needed.
So a turnover. The Cardinal will have it when we come back. Stanford campus, one of the more beautiful campuses, and one I can tell you hardly anybody on our crew ever went to as an undergraduate or could ever qualify to go to as an undergraduate. And I heartily include myself in that.
I have to admit I wanted to go to Stanford one day too, but no way.
Here's a give this time to Allen, and Allen busts it straight ahead for a first down across the 35 to the 36. Ralph Parent, Marco Williams, and that's been there for the Cardinal tonight.
It really has. They've been able to run the ball very successfully, especially on first down. And first you had Brian Allen start the game, then Carter comes in, gets some big yards, and now they're back to Brian Allen, that 1-2 punch of Allen and Carter.
Send Luke Powell to the far side. Slot line Wells inside of him. There's Allen again. Allen at the left side this time. Picks up about five. Stopped by Vinny Churchu. Churchu was a fullback at Clemson. Transferred to Boston College. Now a middle linebacker.
It's a good middle linebacker name.
Yeah,
Churchu.
It is. Yeah, it
Churchu.
Is.
I'm going to hurt you. Good job on that left side, though, by Kurt Chambers and Eric Heitman. They're doing a good job on that offensive line all the way across the board.
Here's a give to Allen again, and this time Boston College has it all sniffed out. Doug Bissett coming up from the safety position to make the stop.
Doug Bissett hovering around that line of scrimmage in that eight-man front, and he's a guy that likes to get very active in the running game. Last week he had 12 tackles against West Virginia.
He's also a guy that Stanford feels, very honestly, they might be able to take a little bit of advantage of tonight.
Very over-aggressive guy, might be peeking in there on play-action fake later on in the ballgame.
Four wideouts for the Cardinals now. Straight back, Fasani has to roll away from pressure again. Bought himself some time, and now he's going to run. Stiff arms a man out of the way, and picks up a first down at the 46. He's nothing if not tough, is he?
Very tough, very elusive for a big guy, and very strong. You've got to be impressed with him. He breaks out of the pocket, feels the pressure, gets around the corner, then makes a nice little move, and is able to get out of bounds without taking a lot of punishment.
Watch Paul Cook, who's probably feeling right now for his molars.
Here he's rolling out. He's looking to throw the football, there's no question, but he sees there's nobody open. Nice straight arm. Boy, oh boy, you just don't see quarterbacks doing that anymore, and gets out of bounds without taking the big hit. That's what I like about it.
He knocked him down. First down Stanford in Boston College territory. You made this point when we were in commercial break that Stanford's most effective plays have basically been broken plays.
The ones that have broken down, Randy's been able to make something positive out of a negative situation, and that's the sign of a good, experienced quarterback.
Brian Allen gets a couple. He leaves and Carter comes back. He's on the contacting his wristband to see what this play is. Second down and eight. Cassani will go up.
Oh, he's got a man.
Wide open, he's gone. Wells at the 10, at the 5, touchdown. Somebody saw something.
Nice double move by Ryan Wells, and Cassani lays the ball out there. That might have been that play we were talking about earlier where Bissett might have bit on that play. 46-yard touchdown pass. Great play action fake. A lot of people froze. Here you see the fake to Carter. Lays it up there under pressure. He has to wait on a little bit. Nice move by Walls and gets into the end zone.
Stepped out of a tackle nicely too. Parent just came up empty. Thought he had him. Baselli tried for point. It is up and good, and Stanford has taken the lead in this ball game, 14-7, with 9 minutes, 41 seconds remaining to be played in the second quarter. 46-yard touchdown pass, Fasani to Wells. Yards on the scoring pass from Fasani to Wells. Interesting one. Fasani is 3 for 10. His first one was for -1. His second was for an 18-yard touchdown, and his third a 46-yard touchdown.
Big plays. It's either a negative play or a big play for Randy tonight, and hopefully he has more big plays by the end of the game. So I'm sure that's what Stanford wants, more big plays.
Camella and Burke are the deep man to receive this kick from Bissell. A short kick again. And this is going to be Burke at the 6-yard line. Starts the other way. He's going to have a lot of room at the 20, at the 25, and trips and falls at the 25-yard line. And he looked like he was going to have a lot more than that. Well, that touchdown was quite an adventure for free safety Ralph Parent.
No question. Ralph Parent got caught peeking in the backfield. Watch him come up right here in the screen. And number 19, Sheen, they both bite on the play-action pass. Wells just gets behind him and just waiting on the ball. This is one of those, please don't drop the football. Then Parent does something doubly wrong on this play, misses the tackle at the 5-yard line. Wells goes in for the touchdown.
So a tough turn of events for Parent. For Stanford, a 7-point lead. They give it Green straight ahead. Green moves the pile across the 30 to the 32-yard line. A gain of 7.
That was Green's longest carry today. Up until then, he had 8 carries for 0 yards, with 4 of those carries for losses. So he wants to get back on a positive track, and I think he's doing that. His last 2 carries, he's had positive yards.
St. Pierre, incidentally, is back at quarterback for the Eagles. Second down and 3. Green again. And he stopped for another loss. Friedrich's first man to him with plenty of help from his friends.
I tell you what, when you're the leading rusher in the nation, you're going to attract a lot of people. And there's a lot of red shirts around that football. They are definitely on Mr. Green tonight.
He's got a bullseye on him tonight, doesn't he?
They're going to have to find another way to beat this team. But you know, great running backs find a way. And somewhere, somehow in this game, if he's a great one, he's going to find a way to make yards.
And he's a big, strong guy, too. Struggling tonight, but don't go anywhere quite yet. Out of the shotgun on third down. They pick the blitz up. St. Pierre throws over the middle. It's intercepted. Picked off by Brian Taylor. Taylor's at the 15, the 10, the 5, and stepped out of bounds at the 9-yard line. And there's a pass that Brian St. Pierre would dearly like to have back.
He really would, because there was great coverage on that particular play, and he just stepped right in front of the football, made a great catch on the football.
It will not be a touchdown. It's coming back to the 9-yard line, but look at this.
Watch Taylor step in front of that ball and make a nice catch. You don't see defensive backs make good catches like this. Then he turns into a runner and almost had a touchdown. Just stepped out of bounds right there at about the 9-yard line. But big play for Stanford again in this ball game. Here you see the receiver runs a little drag route across the middle, but watch him step underneath, right underneath, and make the play. Good catch again and turns into a runner. Positive play for Stanford.
This is Kerry Carter on the first snap. Gets it inside the 5-yard line to the 4. Carter running hard tonight.
That ball almost came out, too. He's got to hang on to that football, especially down here in the red area. You don't want a turnover.
Well, Stanford, after starting rather slowly, is starting to get into a rhythm, and you really sense a big momentum change in this game right now.
You know, they got those jitters over with. They made some mistakes early in the ball game. They were able to survive and keep the score tied. It should have been a lot worse. And now they're starting to play Stanford football.
Carter and Newberry, the running backs in the I formation behind Cassano. Carter again. Right back over the middle and a cutback into the end zone. Touchdown, Cardinal.
Nice read by Kerry Carter on that left side. Nothing but a little blast play off tackle. You see he cuts it all the way back to the right and heads those shoulders upfield. Touchdown.
I believe it was Quame Harris who gave him a great block to clear the way with that cutback. Vaselli will try to add the 21st point. And he got it up and through. And just like that, with 7:36 left in the half, Stanford has stretched its lead to 14. Welcome back. 21-7, Stanford leads. And again, we talked about the experience of this offensive line and that being the strength of this team. We will see it after this kickoff. BC now has coughed it up a couple of times on picks, and both were converted into Cardinal touchdowns. So they got to get things turned around here. Here's Burke. And a flag down. Burke at the 20, 25. Gets to about the 32, but I think they're going backwards. Block in the back, and it's going the other way. So St. Pierre will start deep in his own territory. Great blocking down near the goal line. You see that guy in the background. Watch the block by 77, Quame Harris.
Quame Harris, sometimes the point of attack isn't always the most important blocks. The backside blocks are very important blocks, too. And you see Quame Harris really seal off his man, allows Kerry Carter the ability to cut back and make the run, get those shoulders square, and get it over the goal line for the touchdown.
Jared Newberry also with a key block on that play. But that is the strength of this Stanford team this year. It's very experienced. Quame Harris, of course, is just a sophomore. It's interesting. We see it's a very experienced line, and they have two sophomores.
The thing that's good, though, is the middle of the line where you have your center and your two guards. Those are three seniors, and that's where you want to have that experience on the offensive line.
St. Pierre, quarterback, play fake, going to throw. Throws from his own end zone, caught by Sean Ryan, the tight end, and that'll be close to a first down at the 19-yard line.
Nice misdirection, naked bootleg by St. Pierre this time. He gets the whole flow of the line going to the left and comes back to the right and has his tight end, Sean Ryan, wide open in the flat. Delivers a nice soft football for him to catch, and he makes some positive yards.
good confidence builder for him, I think.
Especially after coming back from an interception, you want to give him something that he can get on the move, he has the run pass option, and something that's very high percentage.
And it is a first down. First and 10 at the 19-yard line for the Boston College Eagles. So the Eagles with a first down. St. Pierre, the quarterback. Green on a little bit of a delay and gets it to about the 24-yard line. Gain of almost 5 yards on the play. Craig Albrecht and Coy Wire on the stop for the Cardinals.
Just like a good quarterback, a good running back needs some type of running plays to get him into a rhythm, too. He's been trying to bounce him outside. Now they're just letting him run straight at that defense and create some seams and get some positive yards. Get his shoulder pads square to the line of scrimmage.
Second down. About four. St. Pierre has to roll away from pressure. Throws underneath. Green with the catch and the first down just short of the 30-yard line. And with that, we go to the sideline once more. And Jimmy Watson. Jimmy?
Barry, college football games always bring out the big stars. We found one roaming the Boston College sideline. This is Tim, of course, he's the star of the FX series, Son of the Beach. What are you doing here, you BC
Boston
guy?
Boston College, class of 98. I'm sorry. Did I say 90? I meant 78. I'm sorry.
You know, things, I know you're standing around the scoreboard. It's not going so well for Eagles right now.
It's not going well, but there's a big difference between BC football now and then. They do not serve beer in this stadium. What is up with that?
Yeah, it's the new PC. Oh, who's boy. This good-looking guy standing there?
Doyle, put into a BC game up from Santa Barbara. We're having so much fun.
Doyle, you a BC fan, too?
Yeah.
What about Son of the Beach? Does he let you watch that show?
Yeah.
I think your dad's a funny guy?
Yeah.
Look at that. You got him brainwashed. You got at least one.
I'm such a bad parent. He's been on my show.
What's going on with Son of the Beach? You guys heading for your third season?
Third season starts shooting in December. Writing it right now. Everything's just going great.
So all I'm saying is you work on the beach with a bunch of girls in bikinis. Sounds like a pretty good gig, huh?
Every Boston College, male Boston College graduate's dream.
I'm calling you back. All right, well, good luck to be. Good luck season, Son of the Beach.
Thanks a lot.
It's on Tuesday nights at 10?
Tuesday nights at 10 on FX.
Tuesday nights at 10 on FX. Send it back upstairs to you guys.
All right, thanks very much, Jim. They don't serve beer, I don't believe, in any college stadium. Obviously an NFL fan. There's a give to Green. He gets a little gap this time and gets across the 35, about the 36-yard line. Third down and a short three. Three wideouts for BC. St. Pierre going to throw. Three-step drop. Throws. Little fly that time for DeWalt and DeWalt, or rather for Reed. And Reed actually had a step, but St. Pierre threw it a little behind him.
Looked like there was a little miscommunication on that play where Reed was going deep and St. Pierre was throwing the ball like a little shorter than that. And he got a little pressure also, and I guess he had to release it a little bit before he wanted to. It's kind of tough when you got a guy hanging around your legs to deliver a nice pass.
Yeah, Stanford's starting to get a little bit of push now on St. Pierre. So the Eagles will have to give it up again. Hey, Stanford comes after this one and almost got it again. Powell will let this one hit, and it'll take a BC bounce inside the 15-yard line. Cardinal came very close to blocking that one again. They blocked one earlier. It was Gary Cobb that time who almost got a piece of that ball. There's a guy who played a little quarterback in the NFL.
Played a lot of quarterback, and this guy was one of my arch rivals, John Elway.
How about this guy, babyface, still babyface.
Still out there, still doing it down in San Diego.
Hasselbeck, who I think is going to do a good job. I know you did the Seattle preseason.
I watched him all preseason, really off to a great start. I think he's going to have an excellent year. And his younger brother, Tim.
Chris Lewis is now the quarterback for Stanford. Speaking of quarterbacks with a heritage, you go back a ways with Chris.
You know, Chris is an excellent volleyball player a lot of people don't know about, and my daughter plays volleyball, so I always run into Chris and his father back at the National Volleyball Tournament, and I guess Chris has been asked to play on the Stanford volleyball team, and it's something that, you know, Coach Willingham says, hey, you can do it if you want to, but you want to play quarterback?
It's tough. Lewis this time rolls out, tries to roll away from trouble. Now he throws. Got Luke Powell out there. Powell diving attempt. Did he get it? No.
Wow, nicely thrown football. Rolling to his left, throws back to his right. Oh, great, great pass, but just a little bit too far.
Well, Chris Lewis will be the quarterback at Stanford for the next couple of years. He's got 3 years of eligibility. That was he put it in a place where only his guy was going to get it.
And that's what you want to do when you're throwing towards the boundary. Get that ball only where your receiver or it's out of bounds for a long incompletion, but no interception, more importantly.
He made some big plays last year when he came on for the injured Fasani. He won the Texas game in the last minute. He won the USC game in the last minute. Gives on a draw play this time. And Allen cannot really get started. So it's going to be three and out for Stanford. Douglas Goodwin made sure that didn't go any further.
Doug Goodwin's been making good penetration all day long, and here he sniffs out the draw play on his way to the quarterback. But I've watched him most of the ball game. He's really had his way getting in that backfield.
Interesting, I think, to see if the Eagles come after this one. Eric Johnson looked like he was a little slow getting that ball away last time. DeWalt is the deep man. Johnson, low snap, and a low wobbly short kick. That will go out of bounds somewhere around the 37 or 8 yard line. John McAvoy, good field position here for St. Pierre. There's Green, 35-30, out of one tackle, 25-20, and out of bounds. And that is what William Green did all day last week.
I tell you, it's just hard to keep the good ones down. You know, you can tackle him for a loss, think you have him hemmed up, and here he comes off the right side, hits the seam, watch him run away. Number 13, Tank Williams, who is a very, very good football player. This guy has speed and he's very strong.
Mark Colombo, the right tackle, also really helped him. Stayed on his block. Gain of 20. And a first down at the 17-yard line. We'll go out of the I formation once again. Here's Green again. And Green this time stopped as he got started. Not much up the middle for William Green tonight. Matt Friedrichs on the stop from his middle backer position for the Cardinal.
Stanford D-line doing a good job of getting penetration, and that's what you have to do against a great running back. Get penetration up the line of scrimmage so he can't have that two or three way go. Make him go where he does not want to go.
Nickel defense for Stanford on second down at 9. The Eagles will go on a shotgun. St. Pierre straight back, throws over the middle, incomplete, intended for Frank Mizzarelli, the tight end. Or J.P. Comello was the intended receiver, I beg your pardon, coming from the fullback spot. Camelo leaves now, and Ryan Reed will come back into the ballgame. He's been the big playmaker so far tonight for BC.
JP has a brother in the National Football League right now with the New York Giants and played his college football right here at Stanford.
Out of the shotgun, St. Pierre with time. Close for the end zone, and too tall, intended for Burke. Burke had him on a half a step. Would have had to be a perfect ball.
Would have had to be a very perfect ball. You run out of room there in the back of the end zone. He probably was a little late in delivering this football and would like to keep it more to the inside.
Carter covering did a pretty nice job on Burke.
The thing I like, though, is that ball, if his guy didn't catch it, nobody catches it.
So a 33-yard field goal try for Kevin McMiler. Perfect last week. Very much in his range. Got this one up. And did not make it. Missed it. Off to the right. Washington, of course, with a big win today at home against Michigan. There's a give to Carter on first down. And Carter taking people with him across the 25 to the 27. Boy, is he alone.
I'm really impressed with Kerry Carter. He keeps the leg drive moving. Always going north and south. That's what you want out of your running back. You don't want those guys who are trying to bust it to the outside all the time. He's going straight up there, making people miss and keeping those feet churning.
So it'll be second down and a long two. Time not really a factor, just inside of 2 minutes remaining in the half. Give it to Carter once again, and Carter again moves the pile. He'll have a first down. That'll stop the clock, at least for the moment. There's some numbers on Kerry Carter. Led Stanford last year, despite splitting time with Brian Allen, as he will this year. And again, they really give an opponent a very different kind of look. And here's what the running back tandem has done. 941 yards a couple of years ago, and then 1,189 yards this year, and they expect more. Well, last year, I should say, and this year they expect more. They stack the receivers to both sides. Interesting set. And they give it to Carter straight ahead. Carter's got about four more. Antonio Garay makes the stop.
Nice job of showing four wideouts, a spread set, but then run the ball right up inside, creating some nice seams inside for the running game.
Eight carries, 45 yards for Carter now. And the clock continues to tick down. Stanford still has all three of its timeouts. Second down. Fazzani throws, got a man. That's Wells out of bounds at the 45-yard line.
I really like what they're doing right here. They're taking their time. They're not taking any unnecessary risks deep in their own territory. And I think now that they've gotten the ball up around midfield, you might see them open up their two-minute passing game a little bit.
So it'll be a first down for the Cardinal. 50 seconds left. And as you said, the Cardinal still has all three of its timeouts.
And that's a lot of time in college football because the clock stops after every first down plus three timeouts.
Brigham Young today playing across the Bay at Cal. And two touchdowns in the last 52 seconds of the first down. There's Wells again, and he didn't get out of bounds. They're going to keep the clock going. So back to action, second and five now. Ball still short of midfield. Luke Powell comes in motion. Fazzani straight back, all out blitz. They pick it up, Fazzani throws for Powell on the sideline. And again, that might have been a little bit of a miscommunication. Powell broke off his pattern, and I think Fazzani is actually saying something to him here.
That was a little risky pass right there. He did a good job of standing in there under the pressure, but to throw that ball all the way back across the field like that, that ball was in there a long time.
So now a third down play, and the Cardinal has to worry about making a first down before they worry about the clock and how much time is remaining. Now go out of the shotgun with a slot left. They have three wideouts. You saw the numbers on Fazzani, but three of those five passes were for scores. Here's a blitz again. They pick it up. And Fazzani throws off his back foot as they didn't pick up Paul Cook.
Kerry Carter's got to do a better job of getting a bigger piece of that man blitzing in there. And that time he didn't. And he got pressure on ball away. Watch Carter. He's got to get his body over there quicker so he can get a bigger piece of that guy blitzing in there to stop his momentum. That time he didn't.
So now Johnson will come on to punt. Dedrick DeWald hopes to have a chance. Now play for the run back. Johnson, they might give him a chance. DeWald just lets it go. It hits at the 14, bounces inside the 10, rolls to about the 6-yard line.
Let's just kneel it down, go in the halftime, and make some adjustments and try and come back and play better in the second half.
Sampier takes a knee, and with that, the first half will come to an end. And a look at the scoreboard shows the Cardinal 21 and Boston College Eagles 7. Luke Powell really set the tone for this Stanford team. He's a big play guy, and he had a 49-yard punt return here.
Nice job of getting up in the seam. Nice speed and great move here on the punter, McMiler. Look at those spins, boy. He's going to like those in the highlight film. And he stays on his feet, gets extra yards after the play.
And then the touchdown pass.
Nicely delivered ball off a great play-action fake where he had the corner and the safety suck up on it. Wells makes a great job after the catch, breaks the tackle with the five, and gets the touchdown.
And the Stanford band on
the signing of the
fact that school is not yet in session and won't be for another couple of weeks here at Stanford, but the band always on hand. All right, right now let's go down to the field. Jim Watson is with Ty Willingham. Jimmy.
Coach, they said the first game of the year, you learn a lot. What'd you learn about your team in the first half?
Well, first of all, really what we're hoping is when we had a plan in place that we needed to just play even with Boston College. And luckily, we found a way to get a couple touchdowns ahead. But if we could stay even with them, then we would negate their already having played a game and then hopefully get stronger as we go through the game.
Ty, you made a change of quarterback, Chris Lewis, in for Randy Fasani. What caused that?
Nothing caused it. It's part of our plan. We've got a good quarterback in Chris Lewis in our backup, and we want to get him some snaps occasionally, but there's no question Randy's our starter.
All right, Coach, thanks very much. Good luck second half.
Thank you.
Tyrone Willingham, the Stanford head coach, got to be pretty happy with that defense, couple turnovers. We'll send you to break. We come back, we'll send you to the far.